See, good morning students. Let us see one more problem from the seventh one. Factorize the following. This is a cubic polynomial. So you have to verify the two properties. What are the two properties? If the sum of the coefficients is zero, then x minus 1 is a factor. Sum of coefficients is zero, then x minus 1 is a factor. If sum of coefficients of all powers of x is equal to sum of coefficients of even powers of x are equal, then x plus 1 is a factor. Let us take the two properties. Here, let us take sum of coefficients. What are the sum of the coefficients? 1, minus 3, minus 9, minus 5. So sum of the coefficients is not equal to 0. Let us take another. Sum of coefficients of all powers of x, that is x cube and x. 1, minus 9, minus 8. Sum of the coefficients of even powers, minus 3, minus 4, minus 8. These two is two are equal. So sum of the coefficients of odd powers of x is equal to sum of the coefficients of even powers of x. So in this case, x plus 1 is a factor of p of x. Okay? So to find the remaining factor, x plus 1 is a factor. So let us divide p of x by x plus 1. Divide p of x polynomial by x plus 1 by general division. So take x plus 1, write p of x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5. So what is the process? Step 1. Hey, here what is the highest power of x? X cube. Here what is the highest power of x? X. Highest power of x in the dividend and divisor. X cube and x. Divide this. X cube by x. X square. Now we write this in the quotient. Write this value in the quotient. So multiply with x plus 1, x square into x plus 1, x square into x cube, x square into 1, x square. So write this in the remainder, x cube plus x square. Now subtract. By subtracting, x cube minus x cube cancel, symbol simply changes. Plus becomes minus. Minus 3x square minus x square, minus 4x square, minus 9x, minus 5. Okay, next step 2. Here, what is the highest power of x? Minus 4x square. Divide with x. Minus 4x square by x. So, 1xx cancel, minus 4x. Write minus 4x in the quotient. So, multiply minus 4x with the divisor, x plus 1. Minus 4x into x, minus 4x square, minus 4x into plus 1, minus 4x. So, write this in the remainder. Minus 4x square minus 4x. So subtract. Minus into minus plus, minus into minus plus. So minus 4x square plus 4x square cancel. Minus 9x plus 4x. That is minus 5x. Minus 5. So again step 3. What is the highest power of x? Minus 5x. Divide with x. Minus 5x by x. Xx cancel minus 5. Write that in the quotient. Multiply minus 5 with the divisor, x plus 1. Minus 5 into x, minus 5x, minus 5 into 1, minus 5. That is minus 5x, minus 5. So, minus 5x plus 5x cancel, minus 5 plus 5 cancel. Why? Because by subtracting, minus becomes plus, minus becomes plus. What we got? Remainder 0. So, that means remainder 0, so x plus 1 is a factor. So, remaining factor is x square minus 4x minus 5. So when you got remainder 0, this quotient is the remaining factor. So now let us see how to factorize this again quadratic polynomial. Okay now? See, let us factorize this quadratic polynomial. So this cubic polynomial we can write x plus 1 is a factor. By finding Wilson method we got this is another factor. So it is a quadratic polynomial. Again, let us factorize this quadratic polynomial using factorization. What is the factorization? So see, you have to learn this quadratic polynomial by factorization method. This is very much useful. What is the method? Take x square coefficient 1 constant minus 5. 1 into minus 5 equal to minus 5. So select two factors of minus 5. That sum should be x coefficient. what is x coefficient? Minus 4. So by adding this 2, you can get minus 4. So we can select these two are factors. So x square, right, minus 4x is minus 5x plus 1x minus 12. Then right, take x common, x minus 5. Take plus 1 common, x minus 5. Again take x minus 5 common, x plus 1. So we get these three are the factors. So the problem is completed. But before we done general division, this we can do by Arnold's method. What we got in the first few steps? We got x plus 1 is a factor of P of x. To find the remaining factor, so let us follow Arnold's method. What is the Arnold's method? X plus 1 equals 0. So that means x equal to minus 1. Take x equal to minus 1. Write the coefficients. Coefficient of x cube 1, x squared minus 3, x minus 9, constant minus 1. So write here 0. 1 plus 0, 1. Minus 1 into 1, minus 1. Minus 3, minus 1, minus 4. Minus 1 into minus 4, minus 1 minus plus 1 into 4, 4. Minus 9 plus 4, minus 5. Minus 3 minus plus 1, 1 into 5, 5. Minus 5 plus 5, 0. We got, this is the remainder. When we got remainder 0, this quotient is the factor. So what is the quotient? Constant x, x square. 1x square, minus 4x, minus 5. Then follow this. Okay, na? I hope you can understand and solve this third one and fourth one. For fourth one, first one same model. For third one, you can follow second property. Sum of the coefficients of R terms. What is R term? X cube coefficient 1 plus 32, 33. Sum of the coefficients of even terms. 13 plus 20, 33. So sum of the coefficients of R terms equal to sum of the coefficients of even terms. So x plus 1 is a factor. So same as usual, you can follow the Arnold's method or general division method. Okay now students? So tomorrow let us discuss remaining 8th, 9th, 10th problems. Okay, hope you all will be practice very carefully.